is second childishness and mere oblivion.
One thing that makes Ian McKellen's one-man Shakespeare show different is that he not only speaks a variety of parts, he then takes the audience into his confidence and tells them what he thinks about the characters in the verse.
Which are the melancholy words of Jaques, a character in the comedy As You Like It, a play by William Shakespeare, which I've never been in.
The other thing that's different is that Ian and everybody else connected with the show are giving their services for the entire run free, with all money going to the Lighthouse Hospice for AIDS sufferers in West London.
Well, AIDS, whether we realise it or not, is a terrible fact of everyone's life. It will be quite soon when we all know somebody who's died of AIDS, as I do. Coming back from the States, where people's perception is much stronger than it is here, I realised that there was help needed, particularly for a project like this, which was in danger of fizzling out for lack of funds. And so the building which is going up in Notting Hill Gate has been saved by audiences coming and seeing my show at ordinary prices, but every penny that they give at the box office, I promise you, goes direct to the London Lighthouse and is converted into bricks and mortar the next day.
Ian hopes to raise over £100,000 for the hospice. He also hopes to give the audience a good time for their money too.
I wanted to tell audiences of all sorts, young and old, whether they knew Shakespeare well or whether they didn't know him at all or had been put off by him at school, that Shakespeare was fun and very available and very theatrical. And I thought the best way I could do that was to convey to the audience my own enthusiasm as an actor for Shakespeare. So what you get in acting Shakespeare is an actor's view of Shakespeare, and indeed Shakespeare's view of actors, and the two are mixed in together.
And Ian McKellen acting Shakespeare opened at the Playhouse Theatre tonight.
When I was rehearsing my Hamlet, I went up to Cambridge to see a friend of mine there, a Don, and I asked him, what am I going to do with To Be or Not To Be? And he said, oh, cut it. So this evening I've taken his advice and you will not be hearing To Be or Not To Be.
But without that famous soliloquy, Christopher Rainbow for Thames News.